Okay, Monday, 23rd of July. Yet again, 5:15 in the morning. Bikes are rolling. I'm doing another stage today on the road to Samarkand, and we've got 2 stages left. But found a hotel on the way, but not exactly sure if there's really a hotel there. We can't find it on Google. But we'll see when we get there. Best thing about cycling at this time of the morning is to see this big, huge red sun coming up from the east there. Of course, we're heading east on this trip, that's why in the morning, facing the sun. So, leaving Navoy. Still very flat here in Uzbekistan between Bukhara and Samarkand. Probably the flattest country we've cycled through so far. Apart from we cycled through a breadbasket in Turkey. It's top of the morning, see people at the side of the road working in the fields and waiting to be picked up in these tiny sooty cars. Watermelon shops on the way. Seems to be the people that work there, they sleep next to their schools. I see a lot of people sleeping outside next to them. Also a lot of car sharing here. People just seem to stand at the side of the road and somebody stops and takes you along. Let's go and get some pictures of that as well. You can see here, people waiting inside of the road trying to flag down the lift. I don't seem to stand there long and a lot of people stop and put them in these tiny cars. See people inside of the road. Hello. It doesn't seem to be a poor country though. You see people of course with donkeys and things, but they don't seem poor. Houses seem nice. Cars are very small but not old. Strange to think that things that are not allowed in Europe, like reversing up a highway, driving in the wrong direction up a highway, just stopping in the middle of the lane to pick up somebody, all things will be completely not allowed and frowned upon. Here, just quite normal. Cyclists going up the wrong side of the road, wrong direction. See it all the time. You have to be aware of the way they drive here. Okay. 8:20, just on the first 50 kilometers, so going quite well today, even though it's a little bit more humid, but doesn't seem so hot yet. So we're going to see if we can do about 80 kilometers today to a town where there should be 2 hotels, but let's see how that goes. I met a guy from Germany yesterday on the side of the road cycling. We just bumped into him again. He's in front of us now. He's also heading for the Pamir Highway. Now we're on the main cycle tourists route now. Overtaken by this guy. He was going faster than us. We're doing 25 at the moment. Uzbekistan is getting greener and greener.
Closer we get now to
Samarkand here, heading east. So we left the desert behind that we came through yesterday. That was quite green. Now we've done 82 kilometers, only half past 10. So. Going okay, really? You okay, Jeremy? Haven't yet. One piece of bread and a banana to do 82 kilometers. Amazing, really.
And stop 5 o'clock when you are very tired.
I miss being able to stop on the way for a cup of tea or a cup of coffee or something.
Yeah.
Heat is gonna beat us.
Get the job done and then have the coffee afterwards.
Yeah, it's just more fun to step on the way, so that's the way it is.
Giving Jamie a cold bottle of water. A busy town here. Let's see if they have a hotel we can stay in. Okay, we're following this taxi to the town. I'll tell you the story in a second while we're doing that. Shop here. I'll show you the hotel in a second. One of those great experiences. This is the local shop here. Going to get some eggs and something to eat. Hopefully, luckily the lady from the guest house is helping us. The bread has turned up. It's very warm.
Okay, so not this. No.
Eggs pieced in tin. Alright. That was the shop. Let me just.
Rusma.
So this is the kind of experience you don't get in the standard hotels. Hello. Jamie can get his big melon back. Melon, okay?
I think Jamie has regretted that he wanted a watermelon.
Are you sure it was a good idea with the watermelon?
Yes.
Is it big enough?
I'm using all my muscles.
After it's 90 kilometers on the bike, then you have to carry a watermelon. Okay, this is the place we're staying. Oh, are you strong? Okay. The bikes are there. This is our room here. Oh, we turned up here in Kattakurgen, that's the name of the town. We plan to do 50 kilometers today to a hotel, but it was going so well, and Jamie got a lot of speed on today, we all had, and didn't feel too hot today, so we decided to carry on to do 88 to Kattakurgen, and we could see this was a little bit bigger town, and there was a motel, so we thought, okay, we'll go for that. We went for that. That went really well. We got here, I don't know, 10:30 or so.
Can I just add that it was at the first hotel, which we couldn't really see from the road. Looks like a very little town. But anyway, they are 8:00 this morning. Yeah. That would be a little bit too early to stop after all.
Yeah, so we decided to carry on to do 88 kilometers, and that went really well. We turned up in the town here, we got to the motel, and the motel doesn't accept international guests because they don't have a license. And then we asked, is there any other hotel? And they said no. So sitting there on the step outside the motel thinking, what do we do now? It's still 70 kilometers to Samarkand, and after 90 we didn't feel like doing that. And looking at the other options, and then a nice lady from the motel came out and says there's actually a home that puts people up. It's about 10 minutes away. So we says, great, we'll do that. So, oh, I think the lady's coming with something. The taxi pulled up and we just followed the taxi here. And now we're in this nice place here. It's like a kind of quite a big house, really, in the town here. And the chickens outside. And so we've got this room here, I can show you. Quite nice. And the kitchen here we can use. Well, just the lady just told us I don't think any of it works. This is our lunch today. Well, lunch stroke breakfast. What we conjured up in the shop there, some eggs and bread. Very even still warm bread.
And juice.
Juice, perfect. Just what we need. So the taxi driver that we followed through the town today, he's brought us here to a nice restaurant. So.
And big.
Snickers cake.
Snickers cake.
Yeah, even too big for me and Jamie to eat. Which,
and I have so much left. Snickers cake. Left.
That's what's left.
Yeah, left.
Oh, we saw the sun come up and now it's just going down. Now. End of another day. This was a kind of a homestay, staying with a real Uzbeki family in a kind of rural place. There's chickens and sheep over there and no air conditioning in the room, it's a little bit hot. We'll see if we can sleep. But they allowed us to stay in there. They've got a living room, actually a really luxurious living room that we could stay in with a big air condition. We've been there all afternoon resting. Now just out for dinner, so quite good really. Good experience again. So tomorrow we're on the bikes heading to Samarkand. It's about 70 kilometers, so we'll be up early again and we should be there before lunchtime if all goes well. So then we'll be in Samarkand for about 5 or 6 days, something like that. So okay, that was the end of today. I'll just show you a little bit around here and then see you tomorrow. You can see the kids are out playing now all this afternoon. They were just in the house. Well, in fact, the whole family was just in the house sleeping. I think here they get up early like we do. And then all afternoon is just spent sleeping, and then in the evenings they're out again. So, hello, hello. So, that's what it looks like, yeah.